الغد وهذا موجز لأهم الأخبار.
The airwaves are their weapon, piercing front lines into the homes of the people of Mosul. And the people of Mosul have found their voice.
والله بصراحة يعني الحياة صعبة بالمصل، يعني اكو كثير بيوت واقعين، وابسط من الناس يعني عمر كان طلعوا قرية كامل، بيت خال ابويا جهزة قاعدين عندنا بهيكل، ولا كهرب ولا مري، يعني المأساة حيل، واحنا يعني خايفين احنا اذا بس لا هذول المناطق الخارج يطلعون. طيب كله يحصروهم بالمصل.
قليل حيل يعني.
It's an interactive show. Another caller has a message for the Iraqi security forces.
أقول لهم من اليوم الصبح 11 كلكم تريلات عايشوا تريلات. أقول لهم بس دير بالكم من التريلات اللي عايشوا فخوها ذا. يعني منطقة نساها اللي اللي يعرف بها.
ISIL has banned mobile phones, radios, and satellite dishes. They don't want anyone inside the city to communicate with the outside world. And this is where this radio station comes in and plays a crucial role.
You have people who are calling the radio station. That's a passive resistance. And you have also the people who are not following Daesh rules, listening to music. All these kind of actions are all symbolic of passive resistance. So no matter if even if you don't have a weapon and you cannot resist Daesh inside Mosul, you still have opportunities to tell how Daesh are acting inside the city.
Most of the people working here come from Mosul. This is their way to help, their way to resist ISIL's presence in their city. An Iraqi army soldier calls in from the front line.
مثلا من غير مناطق او اللي حيجيكم من الجنوب، بالعكس احنا جايين بدنا نحررهم وجايين بدنا نخلصهم من الدواعش، والرساله الثانيه انه لا يطلعوا من بيوتهم، خليهم يظلون بمكاناتهم.
We are told that those who call in seem less afraid than when the station was first set up in March of last year. Then they spoke in whispers, not anymore.
انا ما اخاف منهم لان هم انتهوا بعد، انا ايش اخاف منهم بعد؟ ماكو خوف.
بس نحن نخاف.
هم مزرقين.
ISIL has managed to block their frequency in the past. Now the channel broadcasts on four frequencies at the same time. It makes it much harder to jam, we're told. They are engaged in an information war with ISIL, and it seems, at least to those who manage to listen, that they are winning. Stephanie Decker, Al Jazeera, in the Kurdish region of northern Iraq.